In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep through the jungle.
You know, most artists hope their career lasts long enough to have a greatest hits album. Billy Joel's new album is called Greatest Hits Volume 3. You say to yourself, well, what songs will I find on this Greatest Hits volume? Well, hits like these.
In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep.
As a fan, what are the advantages of a Greatest Hits package?
You know, that's a good question. When I was in my 20s, I had a couple of greatest hits albums of artists, you know, only specials, certain artists that I was crazy about. And now I look in my record closet and it's all greatest hits albums, all the Motown albums I liked, all the R&B albums I liked, all the early rock and roll albums, Beatles, Stones. It's just, they're kind of shortcuts, really. I guess it's an advantage in just, it's, you'll be familiar with most things.
One of the songs you won't be familiar with on this album is a new one, written not by Billy Joel, who writes all of his own music, but by, of all people, Bob Dylan.
Make you feel my love.
It's a funny way how you got the recording of that. Dylan sent it to you. That
I got a copy of the demo that Bob had done, and it hadn't been on a Bob Dylan album. Now, to find an unrecorded Bob Dylan song is like coming across this gem.
I'd go hungry, I'd go black and blue. I'd go crawling down the avenue.
There are those Dylan-esque. I'd go crawling down the avenue, I'd go hungry, I'd go black and blue, you know, that Bob just writes those words he can really chew on.
Well, I'm on the down easter, Alexa.
Tell me about Billy Joel, the writer, writing for Billy Joel, the artist.
I try to change my voice a lot. I try to sound like different people. Sometimes I try to sound like Ray Charles.
I've had friends, oh, but they slipped away.
Sometimes I try to sound like Diana Ross. Sometimes I try to sound like anybody but me. You know, where's Billy's voice?
Can you give me a little of how Billy sounds like Diana Ross?
You know the recording, Tell Her About It?
Yeah.
Well, that was me trying to do Diana Ross with the Supremes. You know, she was always giving girls advice. Listen, girl, that, 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 that.
Listen, boy, I don't want to see you let a good thing slip away. You know I don't like what.
So I was going, listen, boy, I don't want to see you let a good thing slip away. It was kind of a tribute to, you know, soul and Motown and R&B, and I was doing Diana Ross as a guy. Figure that one out.
You know, when you are putting out your Greatest Hits Volume 3, we get to ask you a question like this, which is, when it's all done, how do you want to be remembered?
Well, how would I like to be remembered? I'd like to be remembered for being a good writer, someone that reflected his time. Not so much the performer or the rock star or the singer or the piano player, but the writer. Because to me, that's the hardest part of the gig, is coming up with the material. That's the most fulfilling part of the gig, and the most creative part for me is the moment of creation. And it would be nice to be remembered for having written music that reflected my time.
He does reflect his time. One of the things Billy told me was that his future recordings will be classical, no lyrics, just music, but he'll still be touring with Elton John next year.
You just hear that voice and it takes you back. Mm-hmm. CDs?